Managing your files on your PC and in the cloud. Hi everyone, I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. I have one desktop computer in the office, one at home, a laptop at home, and an iPhone. I have OneDrive, Dropbox, Google Drive, and iCloud. I do presentations using PowerPoint. I plan to use OneDrive as the main cloud storage. I've been having many versions of the same presentation, which is confusing. What's a good way to use when preparing a presentation? Should I work on the native computer and then save it to the cloud, or should I start in the cloud all the time and then save it to the computer? This concept of saving it in one place or the other basically belies a fundamental misunderstanding of exactly how these cloud services work. So what I'm going to do is walk you through exactly what these things are doing, how it's going to work for you with both your PC and the cloud, and then also share some rather strong opinions about how you might consider organizing your data. I'm going to use OneDrive as my example. You'll see it here in Windows 11 on the screen. But what I'm talking about will apply to all of these major services, including Google Drive, Dropbox, Proton Drive, and a couple of others. One of the fundamental characteristics of these applications is that they are applications. There is software that's running on your computer. So if we take a look here on my Windows 11 machine, you'll see that there is a little OneDrive icon down below, and I've already brought up the OneDrive personal pop-up menu. This is where the settings are and so forth, all of those kinds of things relating to OneDrive. The important thing to realize is that this is a program running on your PC. What's its job? Why is it running on your PC? Well, it's actually very simple. Behind it, now we have on the left-hand side, I have Windows File Explorer opened on the OneDrive folder on my PC. On the right-hand side, I have a browser, Edge in this case, open to OneDrive.com, the cloud, and is open to my OneDrive account online. So essentially, on the left, we have the PC, and on the right, we have the cloud. Now, the fundamental operation of these utilities is very, very simple. If I, for example, delete a file, this only five things one, which I think is a PDF file, if I delete that here on my PC, you'll notice we get a warning. And now the file has been removed from my PC. And if I go over here to OneDrive in the cloud and refresh that window, the file has disappeared. If I create a new file here on my PC, I'll just create a silly text document. There's new text document. If I, once again, refresh the online version, the online copy of my cloud storage in OneDrive, that file shows up here as well. That's what that application is all about. It is keeping the OneDrive folder on your machine in sync with the OneDrive folder, if you will, in the cloud. What does in sync mean? Well, it means that any changes you make in one place are automatically replicated or copied to the other. For example, now that I've created this new text document on my PC and it has shown up online, if online I decide I want to delete it, then in a few seconds it will simply disappear from my OneDrive on my PC. And there it is, it went away. So this whole concept of synchronization is super important. Now I want to pay special attention to deletion in this case, because I get a lot of questions from people who are upset when they delete a file on their PC, expecting it to remain in the cloud. That's not how this works. The whole concept of OneDrive is to keep the two places in sync with one another. So that means if you were to delete a file on your PC, as I did and as I'm doing once again, then that file is going to be deleted from the cloud. Poof, it's gone. Again, that's an important concept, this whole concept of keeping your PC and the cloud in sync at all times. So what does this mean for your presentation? It's actually super simple. I recommend generally that whenever you're working on files, regardless of whether they are going to be in the cloud or not, that you work on your PC. It'll be faster, more generally, if you're using, depending on the application you're using, you'll have a more fully functional application on your PC. But bottom line is, do the work on your PC. Now, as long as you do that work on a file that is stored within your OneDrive folder, so for example, you might create your presentation within the OneDrive folder on your PC, then it will automatically be updated every time you save it to disk in the cloud. So you'll actually have it in both places. You didn't have to do anything. You didn't have to upload it. You didn't have to put it in the cloud yourself. The mere fact that the file lives within your OneDrive folder and the OneDrive app is running on your PC means that it will be automatically uploaded and updated as you make changes in both the PC location and the cloud location. That's my recommendation. Do the work on your PC in the OneDrive folder, and then make sure that the OneDrive app is running. And now you'll have that file, that presentation will automatically just show up in both places. Now, you also mentioned something about different versions of the file, and I'm not necessarily sure exactly what you mean by that. I suspect that because you've got all these different cloud services and are kind of unclear as to how the cloud thing works, that it may just be you're saving it more often than you need to. On the other hand, one of the things that I run into quite a bit is saving different versions of the same file. Let's set the cloud aside for just a minute. One of the almost stereotypical scenarios that we see in business all the time is somebody whose document has been updated and updated and changed, potentially by other people, especially, you know, if you're sharing it in the cloud. But what they end up doing is they change the document name to reflect the version of the document that they're working on. Eventually, that kind of sort of cascades into a really messy file name. The example that I use in the companion article for this video is my important letter -2024-5-04.1.23.final.reallyfinal.reallymeanitthistime.okayoncemore.docx. In other words, it's the classic thing of you think you're done, but you're not, but you don't want to use the same file name for some reason. Don't do any of that. That is fundamentally wrong, in my opinion. You have one document, a master copy of your document that you're working on. It doesn't need a version number in the file name. You can have version numbers inside of the document. That's great. That's a great way to track what's going on in that document. But by and large, you do not need to have a version number or a revision or a whatever in the file name. So my recommendation, for example, in my example, would be myimportantletter.docx. That's it. That's the name of the file. No matter who's editing it, no matter how many edits are made to it, no matter what version or revision happens to be. What if you want to save older versions? What if you want to save the progress being made on that document? Great. In potentially the same folder as the document, or somewhere else, create an archive folder. Then, when you need to save a version of a document before you start working on it, copy the document to the archive folder. Then, maybe, sure, give it a name in the file name. My document dot, and then some date, for example, dot docx, so that you've always got a history of exactly which document is which as you go on. But the main document, the current document, the master copy of the document does not change its file name. It's always the same thing you work on. And that way, it's very clear which document is the current version of the document and where you might find older versions if you need them. So that's my recommendation for how you handle different versions, different copies of documents as you're working on them. But ultimately, this can all happen in OneDrive or in whatever cloud service you're using. Because again, if you create an archive folder on your PC within the OneDrive folder, well, you'll be creating it online as well. If you copy your document into the archive folder within your OneDrive, well, they'll be copied into that folder online too. So you're basically getting the benefit of cloud storage as kind of, sort of a backup in progress and a way to clearly edit and save the documents you care about. I hope that helps clarify a little bit of what's going on. I mentioned that there's a companion article for this video that's actually true for most of my videos. You'll find it at askleo.com/171219. You'll find any updates, some related links, comments can be placed there as well. And as I said, I hope this helps. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.